All right, so with next gen right around the corner, we've all heard about the news on how much stuff is going to be at a whole nother level. So leave a like on this video for 2K21 next gen to have all type of new badges and having the best badge system possible.
I got digital dash, can't ride with a op. I walk in the store and I buy the stock. I hide in the bins and pull out the lock. Got Tiffany diamond, it cost me a lot. They flying like birds, but drop on this hot. 400 degrees, I burned up the block. Burn out, make one call, they turn out. CC the gang, get the word out. When the shit getting hot, you the first out. Cover my wrist with a watch and I flood it with rocks. Now I look at the time all day. Be high, I ride through your block and I drop off the top. And I know you can see my face. You my dog at the end, don't care what the bitches say.
Yo, what's up to YouTube? It's your boy Fizz back with yet another video. Today I got you guys with the best badge setup after patch 4 for every build and any amount of badge degrees. So I'm gonna be going over 1 through 15 for the gold for the guards and 16 through 30 for the guards on Hall of Fame. And I'm gonna do that again for the bigs, but I'm gonna do this for the finishing, the shooting, the playmaking, the defensive, all in one video. So yeah, I'm gonna be doing that all in one video. And every one of these videos on Banger Week, I'm gonna be giving you guys a code, but I'm gonna do the code right here in the beginning of the video because this video is going to be so long. I'm not really expecting people to watch the entire video. So yeah, I'm gonna be having a code somewhere within the intro. So make sure that you see that. So next, I want to go ahead and get this out the way. I did the playmaking based off the ankle breaker not being as overpowered as it is. So keep that in mind. So if you want ankle breaker, go ahead, put that on at your own risk. Now, you don't necessarily need ankle breaker to take ankles. That's another thing that went to my actions. But if you want to be able to get more ankle breakers, put on ankle breaker. That's what I would say. But yeah, that's going to be pretty much all I have to say before we get into this video. So yeah, like I said, I'm going to be going over 1 through 15 for the gold, 16 through 30 for the Hall of Fame for guards and bigs, for the finishing, the shooting, the playmaking, and Hall of Fame. So yeah, man, for that alone, go ahead, leave a like on this video to support. If you guys want more videos come out as soon as possible in this Banger Week, go ahead, drop a like. Subscribe if you are new. We on that road to 100K, so I really would appreciate it if you drop that sub. But yeah, man, without further ado, let's go ahead, hop straight into it. Alright, so hopping straight into it for the guards, we're gonna go over the first badge upgrade. For the people with one badge upgrade, you're gonna be putting that joint strictly to Slithery Finisher. That's going to be the best finishing badge in this game. It's gonna pretty much make you dunk as much as possible and get you the best animation possible as much as possible. And that's very important in this game. And the dunking tendency in this game is actually very high. So yeah. Alright, for the second badge upgrade, you're gonna be going from bronze to silver Slithery Finisher. For the third badge upgrade, if you have three badge upgrades, you're just gonna be putting Slithery Finisher on gold. So yeah, you're gonna pretty much have that at the best possible ability for any people that cannot get Hall of Fame badges. Yes, again, this is for the guards with only gold badges. All right, next for the fourth badge upgrade. So if you have four badge upgrades, you're gonna be having gold Slithery Finisher, and now you're gonna have bronze contact finisher. What this is gonna do is pretty much help you get more contact dunks, or it's just gonna help you finish through contact dunk in any type of way, you know what I'm saying? So if you're going up for a dunk and there's somebody trying to jump with you, it's gonna let you finish that dunk more. If you're going up with a layup and you're getting into contact, it's gonna make you do that. Now, contact finisher does have a lot of negatives to it where it makes you do bad animations, but that's why we have Slithery Finisher on first. Now, for the people that's wondering what this contact dunk is gonna do. So if you have the contact dunk packages, that's 20%. We don't know if this is confirmed this year, but this is how it was last year, and a lot of stuff has been copy and paste, and it might be even higher this year, and it's way more noticeable, but it's 20%, and then if you put a badge upgrade on, that's 15% on top of that, so that's at 35% now. All right, next, for the fifth badge upgrade, for people that have five badge upgrades, you're now going to be going from bronze to silver contact finisher, and if you have the contact dunk packages and you want to be able to get contact dunks, that's now going to be able to have a 50% chance of getting a contact dunk. And now for the people that have six badge upgrades, you're gonna now have gold contact finisher, where you're gonna be pretty much negating everything that's the negatives with Slithery Finisher. And now you're gonna be having that joint on gold, and now you have a 65% chance of getting a contact dunk. So yeah, man, that's going to be the best badge setup for people with six finishing badge upgrades. All right, next, for the people that have seven badge upgrades, you're now gonna be putting it on Relentless Finisher. Relentless Finisher is a very good badge when it comes to finishing layups, dunks, alley-oops. It doesn't really matter, especially when fatigued. So yeah, man, Relentless Finisher is actually a very important badge. For the people with 8 badge upgrades, you're going to be going from bronze to silver, Relentless Finisher. And for the people with 9 badge upgrades, you're going to be going from silver to gold, Relentless Finisher. And that's going to be pretty much the best possible Relentless Finisher you're going to have for people that do not have Hall of Fame badges. All right, next is going to be a very important badge, but not the most important badge, but it's definitely one of the most important badges in this game for finishing, and it's going to be Consistent Finisher. Now, there's a lot of people probably wondering why you're missing layups, especially if you get any percentage. So this is how it works this year. If you have any percentage on any type of layup, you get any type of percentage for your contest, you have to time that well. If you time it bad, you have a high chance of missing it. What Consistent Finisher does is pretty much cancels that out and makes it go in a lot more. So the higher you have that, the more you're gonna be making layups. And now it's pretty weird to time layups every year in 2K, so I don't expect people to really be greening every single layup, and Consistent Finisher is a very good one. If you time your layups good, you can just go pro touch, but I would just go with Consistent Finisher, because if you're timing it good, you're gonna be making it either way. All right, next, for the 11th badge upgrade, you're gonna be going with Consistent Finisher on silver now. And for the 12th badge upgrade, you're gonna be having the best layup badge in the game at gold, and that's gonna be helping you make your layups at the highest rate possible. All right, now for the 13th badge upgrade, probably the most underrated badge in the game this year, which got nerfed a lot, but it's still a very good badge when it comes to hop steps, spin layups, anything like that, is Fancy Footwork. It's gonna really be making those animations a lot faster and help you get around defenders. And yeah, we're gonna be putting Fancy Footwork to bronze for the 13th badge upgrade. For the 14th badge upgrade, we're gonna be going from bronze to silver Fancy Footwork. And for the 15th badge upgrade, we're gonna be going for gold Fancy Footwork. So at the end of all this, when it comes to gold, we already did 1 through 14 for the end of it. So now that we have 15 badge upgrades, I can go over everything that we have now. We have Fancy Footwork on gold, Consistent Finisher on gold, which is the best layup badge, Contact Finisher on gold, which is gonna be giving you a 65% chance of getting a contact dunk if you actually can contact dunks on your build. Relentless Finisher is going to be at the highest rate of helping you be able to make your dunks, layups, contact dunks, lob attempts. It doesn't really matter, especially when fatigued. And then Slithery Finisher is going to be having you dunk at the highest rate possible for anybody that can't get Hall of Fame badges, and it's going to be getting you the best animations possible every single time when it comes to driving to the goal and trying to do any type of dunk, layup, or anything like that. So yeah, man, that's the best finishing badge setup for people with 1 through 15 badge upgrades. All right, now hopping into the guard for 16 through 30 badge upgrades. So for the 16 badge upgrades, you want to start off with Slithery Finisher Hall of Fame. That's going to be pretty much getting you the most dunk animations possible and the best animations possible. Relentless Finisher is going to help you pretty much finish through dunking, through contact, through lobs, contact dunks. It doesn't really matter what you're trying to do, especially when fatigued. Consistent Finisher is the best layup badge in the game, so that's going to be very important to have on Hall of Fame. And then Contact Finisher now at Hall of Fame is going to give you an 80% chance of getting a contact dunk if you have the contact dunk packages equipped. So yeah, man, this is going to be pretty much the best finishing badge setup for 16 badge upgrades. For the 17th badge upgrade, you're now going to be putting on Fancy Footwork to bronze. For the 18th badge upgrade, you're going to be going from bronze to silver Fancy Footwork. For the 19th badge upgrade, you're going to be going from silver to gold Fancy Footwork, and that's just going to be making it that much more overpowered and that much better and making your animations a lot quicker. And at the 20th badge upgrade, you're going to be going for Hall of Fame Fancy Footwork, and that's going to be making your layups when you're doing your rolls, hop steps, spin layups, the fastest animations possible, and be able to pretty much slip through defenders and getting the most stuns possible. Now, the one thing that's really nerfed this year is the stuns, but when it comes to spin layups, these joints are ridiculously fast, and if you put Fancy Footwork on it, it's gonna make it that much more faster. The hop steps a lot faster, and it makes it a lot easier to dunk out of when you have all these other badges along with it. All right, next, we have a new badge. It's going to be for the 21st badge upgrade. For the 21st badge upgrade, you're going to be putting on Bronze Giant Slayer. What this badge does is pretty much cancels out Rim Protector, because Rim Protector unlocks a lot of different block packages. Now, if you have Giant Slayer on, it's going to be pretty much canceling that out. Not only does it do that, it also allows you to not get blocked nearly as much as possible. It cancels out the height advantage in the game, and the shorter you are, or the bigger the height advantage is, the bigger of a difference this badge is going to make. So yeah, man, Giant Slayer is one of the best layup badges in the game. It could arguably be the best layup badge in the game, but this year, with it, you having to time your layup no matter what percentage, I would say Consistent Finisher is, but Giant Slayer is still a very good badge, and that's the 21st badge upgrade we're going to be using. For the people with 22 badge upgrades, you're going to be going from bronze to silver Giant Slayer. For the 23rd badge upgrades, or the people that have 23 badge upgrades, you're going to be going from silver to gold Giant Slayer. And for the people that have 24 badge upgrades, you're going to be going from gold to Hall of Fame Giant Slayer. That's going to be pretty much making the biggest difference on the height advantage issue, the biggest difference on making you not get blocked as much as possible, and the biggest difference on negating the Rim Protector badge, which is very overpowered this year, and it makes a huge difference this year having Giant Slayer with all these builds being so short. So yeah, man, Giant Slayer on Hall of Fame is going to be the badge we are using for the 24th badge upgrade. All right, now for the people with 25 badge upgrades or the 25th badge upgrade, we're going to be going with Bronze Lob City Finisher. Bronze Lob City Finisher is actually a very good badge this year. It's one of the best bronze badges in the game this year. It's going to be allowing you to catch a lot more lobs. It's going to make the lob attempts a lot faster. You're going to be able to catch it to traffic a lot more and all that type of stuff. So, yeah, man, Lob City Finisher is a very, very underrated badge this year. You put it to Hall of Fame, the higher you go up, the more consistent, the faster, the more you can go through and stuff like that through contact, the better the badge is going to be and the better you are going to be at doing lobs. All right, for the people with 26 badge upgrades, we're going to be going from Bronze to Silver Lob City Finisher. For the people with 27 badge upgrades, we're going to be going from Silver to Gold Lob City Finisher. And for the people with 28 badge upgrades, we're going to be now putting on Protest. So it's a lot of people that probably don't really care about Protest. If you don't care about Protest, put on Acrobat, but I would go with Protest. That's just gonna be making you make your layups a lot more. That's gonna be going on top of consistent finishing. That's why I would go with Protest, because it's not just gonna be on acrobatic layups, it's gonna be on all layups. So yeah, I would go with Protest for this one. And that's pretty much for the people that's timing their layups good. And if you're not struggling timing your layups bad, it's gonna go on top of that consistent finisher and make it a big difference. I'm telling you this right now, it's gonna make a big difference. All right, next. Another thing before I go too far, Pro Touch, if you're a person that's using shot stick aiming, you don't even have to really worry about using consistent finisher. You need to use Pro Touch. Pro Touch, if you know about consistent, or not consistent, but shot stick aiming, it's not really about timing. It's about aiming it. So Pro Touch is going to help that no matter what, pretty much. And then, yeah, you got, for the 29th badge upgrade, you're going to be putting on Pro Touch from Bronze to Silver. And last but not least, for the guards, for the 30th badge upgrades, you're going to be going from Silver to Gold Pro Touch. So now we have Gold Pro Touch, Gold Lob City Finisher, Hall of Fame Fantasy Footwork, Consistent Finisher, Contact Finisher, Giant Slayer, Relentless Finisher, and Slithery Finisher. And that's going to be the best badge setup for people with 30 badge upgrades. All right, now moving on to the big man. So this, we're going to do the same method, 1 through 15 for the gold for the big man, and then we're going to go 16 through 30 for the big man. So yeah, let's go ahead and hop straight into it. So for the first badge upgrade, what you're going to be doing is going with Bronze Contact Finisher. Very important badge for big man. You got to at least have it on bronze. That's going to be helping you finish through contact, be able to do more contact dunks and stuff like that, and dunk through traffic. Do layups through traffic, all that type of stuff. So yeah, man, very important for big men where they're going to be going through a lot of traffic. So yeah, man, you want to put that first badge upgrade to bronze at all times. All right, for people with two badge upgrades, you want to go with Bronze Slithery Finisher. Contact Finisher is a very important badge for big men, but at the same time, it has a lot of negatives, and you don't want all those negatives at all times. So you want to put on Bronze Slithery Finisher if you have two badge upgrades. So for the second badge upgrades, we did go with Slithery Finisher Bronze. For people with three badge upgrades on the big men, we're going to be going from Bronze to Silver Slithery Finisher. We're going to be trying to cancel out the negatives on Contact Finisher as much as possible. So yeah, we're going to be going with Silver Slithery Finisher. And for the fourth badge upgrade, we're going to be going with Slithery Finisher Gold. That's going to be getting us the best animations possible, the most dunk animations possible, dunk as much as possible, while also canceling out all the negatives of Contact Finisher. So yeah, that's going to be very important to have for the fourth badge upgrade. All right, next, for the fifth badge upgrade, we're going to be going with Lob City Finisher. A lot of people, when it comes to big, they're going to be doing a lot of pick and rolls, especially for the paint beast out there. So you want to have on Slithery Finisher. Lob City Finisher going to be next for the fifth badge upgrade. Lob City Finisher is going to be helping you pretty much dunk through traffic, catch it through traffic, all the different stuff, and also making your lobs a lot faster. So yeah, man, Lob City Finisher is going to be the badge we put on for the fifth badge upgrade, and this is going to be what your badge setup should look like if you have five badge upgrades. All right, next, for the people with six badge upgrades, you're going to be going from Bronze to Silver Lob City Finisher. And all right, for the people with seven badge upgrades, you're going to be going from Silver to Gold Lob City Finisher. That's going to be putting your Lob City Finisher at the highest rate possible for the people that do not have Hall of Fame. So you're going to be pretty much able to catch lobs through traffic, dunk it through traffic, and have the fastest lob animations possible for people that do not get Hall of Fame badges. All right, next, for the eighth badge upgrade, or people that have eight badge upgrades, you're going to be going from Bronze to Silver Contact Finisher. And for the people that have 9 badge upgrades, you're going to be going from silver to gold contact finisher. We put this on later because you really want to have it on bronze at least, but you want Slithery Finisher more and you want Live City Finisher more, because Slithery Finisher is going to make you dunk more. Live City Finisher is going to be important for catching those lobs. But then you're going to have contact finisher with a finish through traffic, and it's going to be getting canceled out now that you have it gold by Slithery Finisher. So all the negatives that you're going to have in contact finisher is going to pretty much be taken away, but you're going to still have the positives at the highest rate. So yeah, man, you really want to do it like this for the 9th badge upgrade. And if you have 9 badge upgrades, you want to have this badge setup. It's that simple. All right, for the people that have 10 badge upgrades, you want to go with Relentless Finisher. Bronze is going to be having you dunk as much as possible, finish layups as much as possible, and be able to finish lobs a lot more, especially when fatigued. So yeah, man, for the 10th badge upgrade, we're going to be going with Relentless Finisher Bronze. For the 11th badge upgrade, we're going to be going with Bronze to Silver Relentless Finisher. And for the 12th badge upgrade, we're going to be going from Silver to Gold Relentless Finisher. Very, very important. Very underrated. You really want to add this on. At this point, for the people that do not have Hall of Fame badges, you're going to be doing this at the highest rate possible of being able to do layups, dunks, layups through traffic, contact dunks, or even trying to catch lobs and finish it at the highest rate possible, especially when fatigued. All right, next, for the 13th badge upgrade, you're going to be going with Bronze Consistent Finisher. This is the most important layup badge in the game, and this is going to be very important because if you have any issues with making layups because you're getting any type of contest this year, what you have to do is you have to time it. If you're not timing your layups when you get any type of percentage of a contest, you got a chance of missing it, especially if you time it poorly. So then we're going to be putting on Consistent Finisher to cancel out that issue for this year. All right, next, for the 14th badge upgrade, we're going to be going from Bronze to Silver Consistent Finisher. And for the 15th badge upgrade, last but not least, for the gold, for the big man, we're going to be going for Gold Consistent Finisher. Now you're going to be able to finish layups at the highest rate possible. So yeah, you got the best layup badge on gold, contact finisher on gold, so you're going to be actually having a 65% chance of getting contact dunks. For the big men that can get contact dunks, you're going to be having Relentless Finisher on gold. That's going to be helping you finish through any type of situation when it comes to finishing, especially when fatigued at the highest rate possible. Slithery Finisher is going to be having you dunk as much as possible, and you're going to be getting the best animations possible. And then you got the highest possible Live City Finisher, so that you can be able to finish your lives faster and through any type of situation. So yeah, man, this is the best finishing badge setup for the big man 1 through 15 badge upgrades. All right, so hopping into the finishing badge setup for the big man for the Hall of Fame 16 through 30 badge upgrades. So for the 16 badge upgrades, you're going to start off with Slithery Finisher Hall of Fame, Live City Finisher Hall of Fame, Relentless Finisher Hall of Fame, and Contact Finisher Hall of Fame. For the 17th badge upgrade, you're going to be putting on Back Down Punisher Bronze. That's going to be having you pretty much be able to back down your opponents at will whenever you really want to. Now, it's going to really increase the chance of a player successfully backing down their opponent. And a lot of people this year aren't using Moving Truck. A lot of people are 95 strength, but a lot of people are taking risks with going lower in strength and being way faster. So Back Down Punisher is going to be a very good badge this year, I feel like. So yeah, man, Bronze Back Down Punisher for the 17th badge upgrade. For the 18th badge upgrade, you're going to be going with Shaq's pretty much go-to move in the post, Drop Stepper. This is going to be pretty much improving your ability to effectively use drop steps in the post. And drop steps have always been overpowered. So if you're able to move people around in the post, you're going to be able to go along with that Drop Stepper at Bronze for the 18th badge upgrade. All right, for the 19th badge upgrade, you now have on Bronze Pick and Roller. This is going to be pretty much increasing your shot percentage as the roller in a pick and roll. So pretty much anytime you do a pick and roll and you go with a layup, pretty much it's going to increase the shot percentage, even if you're doing a dunk, because you know you can miss dunks in 2K, right? So if you going up with a dunk, it's going to pretty much even make that even higher of a percentage of going in. So yeah, man, Pick and Roller is going to be the badge we go with for the 19th badge upgrade. And then for the people that have 20 badge upgrades, for the 20th badge upgrade, we're going to be going with Bronze Putback Boss. That increases the shot percentage when attempting a putback after an offensive rebound. So pretty much if you get an offensive rebound and you go right back up with it, you have a higher chance of making that shot every single time. And the more you get it, the higher it goes. It's pretty much like Green Machine, but for layups off of rebounds. So yeah, Putback Boss is a very, very good badge in this game this year. They made a lot of these badges a lot more balanced, and Pick and Roller and Putback Boss are some of the big man badges that go under the radar. All right, for the 21st badge upgrade, for the people that have 21 badge upgrades, you're going to be going with Bronze Consistent Finisher. I already went over what this does. For the 22nd badge upgrade, for the people that have 22 badge upgrades, we're going to be going from Bronze to Silver Consistent Finisher. For the people that have 23 badger grades, we're going to be going from silver to gold, consistent finisher. And for the 24th badger grades, for the people that have 24 badger grades, we're going to be going from gold to Hall of Fame, consistent finisher. That's going to be pretty much making you have the best layup badge in the game at the highest rate possible. And so pretty much making you finish your layups at the highest rate possible in any situation, whether you're doing Euros, doing pick and rolls, doing putbacks, you're going to be having that enhanced at Hall of Fame with consistent finisher. All right, for the 25th badger grades, for the people that have 25 badger grades, you're going to be going from bronze to silver pick and roller. For the 26th badger grades, for the people that have 26 badger grades, you're going to be going from bronze to silver putback boss. For the 27th badger grades, for the people that have 27 badger grades, you're going to be going from silver to gold pick and roller. For the 28th badger grade, for the people that have 28 badger grades, you're going to be going from silver to gold putback boss now. For the 29th badger grades, for the people that have 29 badger grades, you're now going to be going from gold to Hall of Fame pick and roller. So you're pretty much going to be finishing in the pick and roll situation now at the highest rate possible, on top of having consistent finisher at the highest rate possible and having contact finisher, slithery finisher, relentless finisher, and lob city finisher all in Hall of Fame. So yeah, that's going to make you in the pick and roll just that much better and glitchy. And last but not least, for the 30th badger grade, for the big men that can get Hall of Fame badges, you're going to be going with Putback Boss Hall of Fame. That's going to be pretty much making you be able to put the ball back up at the highest rate possible on top of contact finisher, silly finisher, lob city finisher, relentless finisher, and consistent finisher. So for the 30 badge upgrades, you're going to be having consistent finisher. That's going to be the best layup badge in the game. Pick and roll is going to be pretty much helping you be overpowered in the pick and roll, making you make everything in pick and roll almost. Putback Boss is going to be pretty much for every time you get a rebound, you'll be able to put that joint back up and have a higher and higher chance of putting that make that. Contact finisher is going to be pretty much giving you an 80% chance of getting contact dunks. And even if you're not getting contact dunks, it's going to help you finish dunks through traffic, get more contact layups to go in. And then you got relentless finisher to go on top of contact finisher, lob city finisher, and slithery finisher. It's going to be pretty much making you make your stuff, whether it's a layup, a dunk, a contact dunk, a contact layup, or even a lob, especially when fatigued. Then you got lob city finisher to be able to have the fastest lob animations, be able to do lobs, do traffic, and just make lobs as much as possible. Then you got back down punisher and drop stepper to just be a threat in the post of any type. Now, if you're a post scorer, I can see those being higher, but not as many post scorers this year to really worry about, and I'm not doing that for y'all, to be honest. But at the same time, last but not least, the best finishing badge in the game, Hall of Fame, slithery finisher. You can use this on bigs, guards, it doesn't really matter. It's going to make you dunk the most possible. It's going to make your dunk tendency way higher. It just makes a big difference on dunking this year. But not only that, it's going to get you the best animations possible. And that's always a very important thing when it comes to playing 2K. But yeah, man, that's going to be pretty much the best finishing badge setup for the big men, 1 through 30. All right, so first things first, we're going to do with the guards. And we're going to start off with the 1 through 15 for the goal. So for the first badge upgrade, or people that have one badge upgrade for shooting, I mean, if you really have one badge upgrade, I would probably say go slippery off ball, because a lot of people that have one badge upgrade is only going to have, you know what I'm saying, no shooting pretty much. But if you do have shooting and you have one badge upgrade, I would go with bronze range extender. But I don't know why you would only have one badge upgrade and you can shoot. But if you can't shoot and you have one badge upgrade, I would say go with slippery off ball. All right, for the people that have two badge upgrades, go ahead and go with silver range extender. All right, for the people that have three badge upgrades, we're going to be going from silver to gold range extender. That's just going to be extending your range as much as possible. What people think range extender is only good for is like limitless range, but it also helps you on deep twos, on the line threes, and deep threes. But what it really does is it makes your green window bigger the closer you are to the rim. You know what I'm saying? It's just that simple. It really just extends your range, and it makes you actually be able to green from further out. And it makes it easier to green from further out. So every single step that you can go further, it makes it easier to just shoot that much more inside your range. So yeah, range extender on gold is what we have on for the third badge upgrade. All right, for the fourth badge upgrade, for the people that have four badge upgrades, we're not going to be putting on bronze corner specialist. Corner specialist is a very good badge, not only for spotting up, but also for fades going towards the corner. So yeah, with this game being the way it is, corner specialist is one of the best bang for your buck badges in the game. All right, for people with five badge upgrades, we're not going to be going from bronze to silver. Corner specialist is the best corner specialist you possibly will want to even have. You don't really even necessarily need to go up in corner specialist. This is the best bang for your buck corner specialist. You're going to get a lot done with silver with corner specialists. And like I said, you can use this for fades. You can use this for spotting up, even if you're on the midi or on the three. It doesn't really matter. Corner specialists are very, very good badge. Very, very OP because you don't really have to necessarily go past silver corner specialists. Up next is another very overpowered badge. Difficult shots is going to be pretty much helping you hit any type of shot, whether it's a fade, hop jumper, anything like that. And in this game where difficult shot type of shots are very overpowered, difficult shots is just going to be giving you an added boost to make those go in a lot more. So yeah, man, for the people with six badge upgrades, you're not going to have on bronze difficult shots. And for the seven badge upgrade, for the people that have seven badge upgrades, we're going to be going from bronze to silver difficult shots. And for the eighth badge upgrade, for the people that have eight badge upgrades, we're going to be going from silver to gold difficult shots. Now we're going to be pretty much be able to hit those high difficulty shots like fades, hop jumpers, spin jumpers, anything like that at the highest rate possible for people that cannot get Hall of Fame badges. All right, for the ninth badge upgrade, for the people that have nine badge upgrades, we're now going to be going with bronze high zone hunter. Bronze high zone hunter is going to be pretty much, when you have hot zones, it's going to be a lot easier to hit shots in general, especially on this game. You really want hot zones on this game. High zone hunter is going to go on top of that and make it a big boost. So yeah, man, high zone hunter is a very, very good badge in this game. All right, for the 10th badge upgrade, for the people with 10 badge upgrades, we're now going to be going from bronze to silver high zone hunter. And for the 11th badge upgrade, for the people with 11 badge upgrades, we're going to be going from silver to gold high zone hunter. Now you're going to be able to shoot the best possible in high zones with high zone hunter, going on top of high zones. And it's just going to be making your make percentage go higher in those high zones. And it's going to be making your green window that much bigger in high zones. It's just going to be making you be able to shoot that much better, especially with high zones. So yeah, high zone hunter gold is the badge we have on for the 11th badge upgrade. For the 12th badge upgrade, for the people that have 12 badge upgrades, you're not gonna be putting on bronze green machine. That's pretty much gonna be helping you green a lot more, especially off of greens. And even after you're greening, it's gonna be making your next shot have an even higher make percentage, which is why it's making you be able to green more consistently and stuff like that. Now the only thing increases the bonus given for consecutive excellent releases. I don't know if it does it the way it did last year where it like keeps increasing it. I'm not 100% for sure. It feels like it does, but I'm not 100% sure that it does. That's what it did last year, but it just says increases the bonus given for consecutive excellent releases. Like it kept on stacking on top of each other, the bonuses. So we don't know if that's gonna stack or if it's just the same bonus every single time, but yeah. Hopefully it is the same way. It was kind of broken last year, to be honest, but with how hard it is to green this year and stuff like that, even with them making the green window bigger, and you know what I'm saying, for some people how hard it is to shoot, even though they made whites go in a lot more, green window bigger, people still are having struggles shooting. But yeah, green machine is the badge we ended up going with for the 12th badge upgrade. And for the 13th badge upgrade, we're going to be going with silver green machine. And for the 14th badge upgrade, we're going to be going from silver to gold green machine. That's going to be pretty much making you have a way higher make percentage after excellent releases, making it that much easier to get more greens. So yeah, man, green machine gold is the badge we put on for the 14th badge upgrade. And all right, last but not least, for the gold side of the guards, we're going to be going for the 15th badge upgrade. We're going to be going on bronze clutch shooter. Clutch shooter in high start, I've said this many times. Very underrated badges. Do you rather have a good start to a game, or would you rather be able to finish a game as efficient as possible, getting as much boost as possible to finish the game? So yeah, we just went with clutch shooter because I feel like that's like the more popular one, that's more known one that people want to use and stuff like that. So yeah, the way clutch shooter is, like, pretty much when it comes to the end of the game, is going to really give you a big boost to be able to make your shots. Hot start is going to be giving you a boost to every single shot that you make off rip until you miss. So it's going to be kind of like green machine, but it's like just going to be giving you a boost on top of a boost on top of a boost every single time you make a shot. And it's going to be getting bigger and bigger and bigger and easier to hit shots and harder to miss. But when you miss, it does nothing. But clutch shooter is going to be helping you no matter what at the end of the game. So that's really never going to end. It's just going to be at the end of the game. It just doesn't begin until the end of the game. It has no effect until the end of the game. So it really depends on what you rather. Clutch shooter, hot start. I put on hot start because I feel like it's the most popular. I pretty much think I would rather hot start, but clutch shooter is pretty much like the more popular of the two, but that's up to you. All right, now we're hopping into the Hall of Fame. So for the Hall of Fame, we have 3 Hall of Fame badges and 2 silver. So we have Hazel Hunter Hall of Fame, Ranger Standard Hall of Fame, Difficult Shots Hall of Fame, Silver Corner Specialist, and Silver Green Machine. So Hazel Hunter Hall of Fame is going to be pretty much giving you the highest make percentage possible in hot zones, which is going to be making it that much easier to green. Ranger Standard is going to be extending your range as much as possible, which is going to be making it easier to make shots and green within your range. And then you got Difficult Shots, so you're going to be able to hit all those high difficulty type of shots at the highest rate possible. You got Corner Specialist, which you do not need to go past Silver for. So you get the best bang for your buck on Corner Specialist. And you also have Silver Green Machine, which is arguably one of the best green machines in the game for the past 2 years, actually. So that's pretty much the badge setup we have for the 16 Badger grades. So if you only have 16 Badger grades, you need to be using this badge setup. And for the 17 Badger grade, for the people with 17 Badger grades, we're going to be going from Silver to Gold Green Machine. And for the 18 Badger grade, for the people with 18 Badger grades, we're going to be going from Gold to Hall of Fame Green Machine. Now he's going to be giving us the biggest make percentage possible after a green, making it that much easier to green after a green. So yeah, man, that's going to be pretty much the best badge setup for people with 18 badge upgrades. All right, for the 19th upgrade, we're going to be going with Tireless Shooter. Tireless Shooter is a very important badge in this game, with the stamina issue being what it is. It improves a player's ability to make shots with fatigue. But if you go to the show more, it's going to show you that when you are fatigued, you lose attributes. You literally lose attributes. So it's like when you're cold, you're going to be losing, you're going to be getting minuses on your attributes. But what it does is it reduces the penalty from when you are fatigued. So it's not only going to be making you be able to shoot better when you're blinking red, but it's also going to be reducing the penalty. So I don't know if it's like, what is it called? Floor Journal, where it does +1 at bronze, +2 at silver, +3 at gold, and +4 at Hall of Fame, which it probably does do something like that. But if it does 2 different things at the same time, it has to be a really, really good badge. And it's one of the best badges in the game. I just didn't really fully understand that it did that until I did the show more. So it might be a lot more people than me that didn't really fully understand that it did that. I knew it did the blinking red, but I didn't know that it actually reduces the penalties that you get when you are fatigued, such as the attributes you lose. So that's pretty important. All right, for the people with 20 badger grades, you're now gonna be going from bronze to silver Tireless Shooter. And for the people with 21 badger grades, you're now gonna be going from silver to gold Tireless Shooter. And for the 22nd badger grade, for the people with 22 badger grades, we're now gonna be going from gold to Hall of Fame Tireless Shooter. And that's gonna be pretty much making you be able to shoot the best possible ability that your player is gonna be able to do when fatigued. So if you are fatigued a lot, Tireless Shooter is going to make a big difference on your make percentage and stuff like that. So yeah. And for the 23rd badger grade, you're not going to be going with Deadeye. Deadeye is going to be pretty much negating the shot contest when people try to close out. On this game, is not the reason I put it on so late. This game, you don't necessarily need it because the shot contest is kind of inconsistent. But if you are a smaller side and you have shorter wingspan, you are going to need Deadeye. So Deadeye is going to be actually very useful for builds like yours. So I would go ahead and put on Deadeye Bronze. It's going to be making a big deal for the 23rd badge upgrade. And then for the people with 24 badge upgrades, you're not going to be going from bronze to silver Deadeye. And then for the 25th badge grade, for the people with 25 badge grades, you're now going to be going from silver to gold Deadeye. And then for the 26th badge grade, for the people with 26 badge upgrades, we're going to be going with Hall of Fame Deadeye. And that's going to be pretty much negating the shot contest on people closing out at the highest rate possible. So yeah, man, Deadeye Hall of Fame is the badge we put on for the 26th badge upgrade. All right, for the last 4 badger grades, I'm gonna just tell you this right now. This is gonna be pretty much the most underrated shooting badge in the game. It really depends on where you're using it. At the park, it doesn't make the biggest difference. When it comes to playing rec or pro-am, it actually makes a huge difference. So for the 27th badger grade, for the people with 27 badger grades, we're now gonna be putting on bronze volume shooter. I need to test this a little bit more, but from my experience, it's been pretty overpowered when it comes to people to green and make your shots. So what it does is it boosts the shot percentages as shot attempts occur throughout the game. And I'm a person that pretty much takes a lot or the bulk of the shots for my team. And if you're a person like that, it's gonna make a big difference whether you're playing park or pro-am. Because if you're taking all the shots, especially on the twos, volume shooter can be very useful, especially if you're playing with a paint beast. I'm just gonna say that. So yeah, it might be one of the most useful badges that a lot of people aren't using this year. So, volume shooter, at bronze is the badge we put on for the 27th badge upgrade. For the 28th badge upgrade, we're going to be going from bronze to silver volume shooter. For the 29th badge upgrade, for the people with 29 badge upgrades, we're now going to be going from silver to gold volume shooter. And last but not least, for the guards, for the 30th badge upgrade, we're now going to be going with gold to Hall of Fame volume shooter. Hall of Fame volume shooter is going to be giving you the biggest boost possible for your shot percentages as shot attempts occur throughout the game. So as you shoot more and more and more, the next shot is going to give you higher make percentage than the next shot, even if you're making or missing these shots. Now, 2K Lab last year did a study on this badge. This was a very underrated badge. A lot of the underrated badges didn't get nerfed this year at all. Like, so you finish it, for instance, actually kind of feel like it got buffed. Volume shooter, from what I've been using, it seems like it got buffed, but I put it at the end because it doesn't work for a lot of people at the park. So it's kind of a badge that you want to use, you know what I'm saying, at the rec and pro-am. I like it at the park because I play twos with a paint beast. If I'm on a playmaking shot creator, if I'm not using a playmaking shot creator, I have no point of using this badge. But yeah, volume shooter is the badge I ended up going with for the last badge. And that's the 30th badge upgrade, and we have it on Hall of Fame. So for the 30th badge upgrade, we actually have Hall of Fame, Range Extender, Hall of Fame, Hazel Hunter, Hall of Fame, Deadeye, Hall of Fame, Green Machine, Hall of Fame, Difficult Shots, Hall of Fame, Tireless Shooter, Hall of Fame, Volume Shooter, and Silver Corner Specialist. All right, now hopping into the big man. So for the big man side, the first badge upgrade we're going to be using for people with one badge upgrade. If you're a big man, I would go ahead and put on Slippery Off Ball if you didn't make a shooter. Because there's going to be a lot of people that didn't make shooters. But if you did make a shooter and you just happen to only have one shooting badge, go ahead and put on Corner Specialist Bronze. At the second badge upgrade, for the people with two badge upgrades, go ahead, go from Bronze to Silver Corner Specialist. Silver Corner Specialist is the best bang for your buck Corner Specialist in the game. You can do a lot with the Corner Specialist. You can do off-the-dribble middies from the corner. Any mid-range in the corner is going to count for Corner Specialist. Anything hashed down on the corner, it's gonna count as corner specialist. So whether you're doing off dribbles towards the corner, whether you're doing standstill, spotting up in the mid-range on the corner, or if you're spotting up on the corner, it's gonna be helping you with corner specialist. So that's why that's the first badge we put on. All right, for the third badge upgrade for the big man, we went ahead and put on catch and shoot. Catch and shoot is gonna pretty much help you shoot in any catch and shoot situation. It's gonna be giving you a boost to any type of catch and shoot situation. So yeah, we did go ahead and put on catch and shoot. Bronze. For the fourth badge upgrade, for the people with four badge upgrades, you're now going to be going from bronze to silver catch and shoot. And for the fifth badge upgrade, for the people with five badge upgrades, we're now going to be going from silver to gold catch and shoot. So now you're going to be able to catch and shoot at the highest rate possible and shoot from the corners at the highest rate possible for people that do not have Hall of Fame badges. All right, for the sixth badge upgrade, for the people with six badge upgrades, you're now going to be going with bronze, high zone hunter. When you have high zones, it's going to make you a lot better of a shooter. When you get high zone hunter on top of that, it's going to be making it that much easier to make shots and get greens, which is a big deal in this game. So yeah, man, high zone hunter is the badge we're going with for the sixth badge upgrade. And for the seventh badge upgrade, for the people with seven badge upgrades, you're now going to be going with high zone hunter silver from bronze, and that's going to be making it that much better. And now for the people with eight badge upgrades, you're now going to be going from silver to gold high zone hunter. That's going to be pretty much helping you shoot in hot zones at the highest rate possible, whether you're trying to make the shot or just get greens. It's going to be helping you out that much. Now, the reason it's going to help you get greens, because as your make percentage goes up, your green window gets bigger, and that's just going to be making it that much easier to get greens. All right, for the ninth badge upgrade, for the people with nine badge upgrades, we now have on range extender. That's going to be pretty much extending your range and making it that much easier to shoot within your range, whether you're trying to make shots or get greens. And it's just going to be making your make percentage within your range higher. So yeah. And for the 10th badge upgrade, for the people with 10 badge upgrades, you're now going to be going from bronze to silver range extender. It's just going to be making you shoot that much better within your range. And for the 11th badge upgrade, we're now going to be going from silver to gold range extender. That's going to be pretty much extending your range the furthest possible for people that do not have Hall of Fame badges. And on top of that, it's actually going to be making you shoot as well as you possibly going to be able to within your range. So yeah, people don't really fully understand what range extender does. I've mentioned this in the guard side. I haven't mentioned this on the big man side, so I'm gonna go ahead right now. Range extender extends your range and helps you shoot within your range. So that meaning deep twos, on the line threes, deep threes are gonna be helped. But it's gonna be helping a lot of different things on how you play. So it doesn't just affect just that. You can do fades and it's gonna be affected as long as it's within your range. It's going to be making it that much easier to shoot that. Whether you're doing catch and shoot situations, it's going to be helping you shoot that within your range. So yeah, range extender is just a very good badge to help you shoot from further distances, especially for lower shooting builds. And all right, for the 12 badge upgrade, for the people with 12 badge upgrade, we now have bronze green machine. Bronze green machine is a badge that's going to be helping you green. So after you get green, it's going to be making your make percentage go up higher. But green machine makes the biggest difference for green window because it actually gives you such a big make percentage. Now, even if you don't green that next shot, it actually going to be helping you make the next shot, because what green machine does is after you green, it really gives a big boost to your make percentage. But it gives you the biggest boost possible because it actually going to be making your green window the biggest possible after each green. And I'm not 100% sure if it keeps stacking and makes it the green window bigger and bigger and bigger as you keep getting greens, but I do know it's gonna be making your green window bigger. So yeah. And for the 13 badge upgrade, for the people with 13 badge upgrades, you're now gonna be going from bronze to silver green machine. And for the 14th badge upgrade, for the people with 14 badge upgrades, you're now gonna be going from silver to gold green machine. That's gonna be the best possible green machine you can have for the people that do not have Hall of Fame badges. And that's actually gonna make a pretty big difference on how much you're gonna be making shots off of greens and how much you're gonna be greening after greens. So yeah. And I went over this earlier, for the 15th badge upgrade, you can go bronze clutch shooter or bronze hot start. It depends on what you rather. Do you rather start off good? Especially if you're a big man. You're not going to be shooting too many shots, you know what I'm saying? More than likely, if you're a spot up. Now, if you're a spot up, some people like to try to die by you shooting. So you might have to shoot a couple. But if you don't have to shoot, but like maybe two, threes a game on a consistent basis because you're playing twos or threes, go ahead and put on hot start. It's going to be pretty much making you shoot the best possible off the rip. And it's going to keep giving you a boost to every single shot until you miss. And then when you miss, it does nothing. Or you have clutch shooter, where it's going to give you a significant boost at the end of the game until the game ends. But before, it's like getting to the end of the game, it really doesn't do anything. It really depends on what you rather. Do you rather end the game off good, or would you rather start the game off good? It just depends on what you rather. So yeah, for the last, on the goal for the big man, we are going with bronze clutch shooter or hot start. Depends on your preference. All right, last but not least, for the end of this video, we're going to be hopping into the Hall of Fame for the big man. So 16 through 30 badger grade. So for the 16 badger grade, you're going to have Hall of Fame catch and shoot, Hall of Fame hazel hunter, Hall of Fame range extender, silver corner specialist, and silver green machine. Now, you might see difficult shots on your screen, but big man, a lot of big men, most big men don't get difficult shots, so I didn't even put that on. So it's going to be people wondering why I don't have that on. There's a lot of people that's not going to be able to put that on. So it was no point. So that's the badges we have. So catch and shoot is going to be making you shoot the best possible percentage in catch and shoot situations. Corner specialist, best bang for your buck, corner specialist. Green machine, very good at silver green machine. Range extender is going to be extending your range to the furthest possible is going to go in the game. It's going to be making you shoot the best possible within your range. And hazel hunter is going to be having you have the highest make percentage in your hot zones. And hot zones automatically gonna be overpowered. Hot zone on top of hot zones is just gonna be making it just that much easier to shoot. So that's very important. Just gonna say that. That's very important. All right, for the 17th badger grade, we're now gonna be going from silver to gold green machine. And for the 18th badger grade, for the people with 18 badger grades, we're now gonna be going from gold to Hall of Fame green machine. Hall of Fame green machine is gonna be giving you the biggest make percentage after a green possible. So it's gonna be making it that much easier to green and or make that next shot. So yeah, man, green machine Hall of Fame is the badge we ended up going with for the 18th badge upgrade. And all right, for the 19th badge upgrade, for the people with 19 badge upgrades, we're now gonna be putting on bronze hot start. You can go with bronze clutch shooter, but I think bronze hot start is gonna be a bigger deal for big men because they're not gonna be shooting nearly as much. And if you don't know what hot start does, it's just gonna be helping you make the next shot and the next shot and the next shot and the next shot and the next shot, until you miss. And then when you miss, you know what I'm saying, it really doesn't do anything. But the thing about it, this year, it does a big boost. A big boost, man. So it actually makes a pretty big difference in the game. Clutch shooter is going to be doing the same thing, but at the end of the game, and it only affects the end of the game. So hot start could eventually affect the whole game. But if you miss, it just doesn't do anything after that. But then clutch shooter could affect just the entire end of the game. You know what I'm saying? It doesn't affect anything but the end. Hot start, though, it could be canceled out after you, if you miss your first shot. So if you miss your first shot, it really doesn't do really much of anything, but yeah. And then for the 20th badge upgrade, you're now gonna be going with bronze clutch shooter. If you didn't go hot start before, you're now gonna go bronze hot start. It's just that simple. what Clutch Shooter does is, I pretty much went over it last time, but I'm going to go over it again. It's going to be pretty much helping you make your shots at the end of the game. It's going to be giving you a pretty big boost to be making you hit whites and get more greens and stuff like that. So yeah, man, Clutch Shooter is going to make a big deal at the end of games. High Start is going to make a big deal at the beginning of games until you miss. So if you don't miss, it's going to actually affect the whole game pretty much. You understand. And then for the 21st Badger Grade, you're now going to be going from Bronze to Silver Hot Start. For the 22nd Badger Grade, for the people with 22 Badger Grades, you're now going to be going from Bronze to Silver Clutch Shooter. And then for the 23rd Badger Grade, you're going to be going from Silver to Gold Hot Start. And for the people with 24 Badger Grades, you're going to be going from Silver to Gold Clutch Shooter. And for the people with 25 Badger Grades, you're now going to be going from Gold to Hall of Fame Hot Start. So you're going to be getting the biggest boost possible off rip to not miss shots until you miss shots. Now, at Hall of Fame Hot Start is one of the most broken, overpowered, underrated badges in the game. Clutch Shooter also. But if you're one of those people that's already good at shooting, go ahead, throw a Hot Start. It's going to be making your margin for error a lot bigger. I'm just gonna say that right now, man. If you have badges to spare, man, High Star Hall of Fame. I'm just gonna say that. You wanna put that joint on. And then for the 26th Badger Grade, you now have Hall of Fame Clutch Shooter. That's gonna be pretty much me making your margin for error at the end of the game a lot bigger. It doesn't even matter if you're missing. It's gonna affect the whole ending of the game and help you make your shots at the end of the game, giving you big boosts at the end of the game to help you get more greens and make more shots. So yeah, man, Clutch Shooter Hall of Fame is the badge we end up going with for the 26th badge upgrade. And then for the 27th badge upgrade, we're gonna be going with Deadeye. I really went with this later into the video because the height advantage in this game actually makes a big difference for the shot contest. So shooting already has a pretty inconsistent shot contest system, and then you don't really necessarily need Deadeye until later. So you could actually argue going with badges like Tireless Shooter if you'd be tired, but I don't really see a lot of spot ups getting tired on offense, so I don't really see why you would need that. If you could get difficult shots, I would say put that on. Maybe Volume Shooter, you don't really shoot that much, so I don't see that. So you could either go Pick and Popper or Deadeye. It really depends on you. Flexible Release is another one, but I mean, I'm not really trying to shoot whites, so that's on you. But yeah, I went with Deadeye Bronze. It's going to be pretty much canceling out the closeouts and making your shot contest that you get or receive, making you get more open shots and stuff like that. For the 28th Badger Grade, you're now going to be going from Bronze to Silver Deadeye. And for the 29th Badger Grade, for the people with 29 Badger Grades, you're now going to be going from Silver to Gold Deadeye. All right, we're going to start off on the guards. For the guards, the first Badger Grade, for the people with one Badger Grade, you're going to put on Quick First Step. Quick First Step is the most important badge in this game. That's how you speed boost, as you get open four threes, mid-ranges, dunks, contact dunks, whatever you're trying to do. Quick First Step is going to help you do that at the highest rate possible because you're going to be able to speed boost. And speed boosting is going to be pretty much making you faster with the ball, which is going to be helping you get open and do what you're trying to do at the highest rate. It's that simple. All right, for the second Badger Grade, for the people with two Badger Grades, we're now going to be going from Bronze to Silver, Quick First Step. And for the third Badger Grade, for the people with three Badger Grades, you're now going to be going from Silver to Gold, Quick First Step. That's going to be having you speed boosting at the highest rate possible with people that cannot get Hall of Fame badges. All right, next for the fourth Badger Grade, for the people with four Badger Grades, you're not going to be having on Bronze Handlers for Days. Handlers for Days is going to reducing the amount of energy lost when performing dribble moves. And that's very big in this game where the stamina issue is at a all-time high. So yeah, man, Handlers for Days is going to be the badge we put on for the fourth badge upgrade. For the fifth Badger Grade, for the people with five Badger Grades, we're now going to be going from Bronze to Silver Handlers for Days. And at the sixth Badger Grade, for the people with six Badger Grades, we're now going to be going from Silver to Gold Handlers for Days. And that's going to be pretty much having your stamina at an all-time high for the people that cannot get Hall of Fame badges. So the stamina issue is going to be counteracted by Handlers for Days at an all-time high. And that's a big deal. I'm just going to say that right there. It's a big deal. All right, next is going to be for the seventh Badger Grade. For the people with seven Badger Grades, we're now going to be putting on Unpluckable. Unpluckable Bronze is a big deal this year. If you don't have Unpluckable on this year, you're going to be getting ripped a lot. Now, as you go up in it, it's going to get way better and better and better. You're going to get ripped at Bronze. But being able to have that on is going to make a big difference from having it on and not having it on. I feel like the stamina issue is a bigger deal, though, than getting ripped. So it really depends on you at that point, but that's just how I feel about it. All right, next is going to be the eighth Badger Grade. For the people with eight Badger Grades, you're now going to be going from Bronze to Silver Unpluckable. And next is going to be for the ninth Badger Grade. For the people with nine Badger Grades, you're now going to be going from Silver to Gold Unpluckable. Now you're not going to be getting ripped at the highest rate. And this is going to be the best Unpluckable you can possibly have for people that do not have Hall of Fame badges. All right, for the 10th Badger Grade, this is a badge that's very glitchy. Floor Journal. If you don't know what this does, is As soon as you put it to bronze, that's plus one to your teammates. Offensive attributes, plus one. Silver's plus two. Gold is plus three. Hall of Fame is plus four. Now, at bronze, it's going to be making a big deal. Say, for instance, somebody's like one off. They have like an 85 ball handle. You get them to that 86. That's going to be making them a bit of speed boost off rip. You got a person on your team that has an 84 three-pointer. You get them up plus one to an 85. Now they're in a tier of 85 three-pointer, making them be able to shoot a lot higher percentage, getting a bigger green window. That makes a big difference. These things where you can make people reach tiers, thresholds, whatever it may be, is a huge deal in NBA 2K21. Bigger deal than ever. Attributes is made a big deal. And anything that can boost attributes, especially shooting, is going to be a very important badge. Alright, for the 11 badge upgrade, for the people with 11 badge upgrades, you're now going to be going from bronze to silver, floor, general. And alright, for the 12th badge upgrade, for the people with 12 badge upgrades, you're now going to be going from silver to gold, floor, general. That's going to be getting you plus 3 to your teammates' offensive attributes. So, say for instance, somebody has an 82 ball handle, or not 82 ball handle, 82 3, you can get them up plus 3, now they're at the 85 tier. Now, if you have somebody with a 96 3, you get them plus 3, that's going to make the big difference, because 99 3-pointer is ridiculous. 85 3-pointer, ridiculous. It's based on tiers in 5s, 85, 90, 95, 99, all the way down to 80 and 75. You can even work with the ball handle. Somebody's like 3 off of ball handle. Somebody's 3 off of speed with ball. If you can get people to 86 speed with ball, 86 ball handle, get them over that threshold where they can speed boost or even momentum, it's going to make a big deal. So, yeah. All right, next for the 13 badge upgrade, for the people with 13 badge upgrades, we're now going to be putting on bronze stop and go. Stop and go is a very good badge. Now, 2K has patched how fast the speed boost is in this game, and they really tried to patch the teleport glitch. But if you want to be able to do the teleport glitch as much as possible, it's not nearly as fast anymore, so... But it's still going to be one of the fastest speed boosts you can get in this game. So if you want to do it at the highest rate possible, put on stop and go. Stop and go is not only important for that, though. It's also very important for to be able to do quick stops. So a lot of people that's watching this video are a playmaker shot creator. So that's like the most popular build in the game. So pretty much everybody has it. So if you want to do the fastest possible quick stops, you have to have on stop and go. And the higher you have it, the faster the quick stops are going to be. The better your stop and goes are going to be. Any type of stuff like that, hezzies and stuff like that. So yeah, stop and go, very important badge in this game. They made it a useful badge this year. That's a good thing. All right, for the 14 badge upgrade, for the people with 14 badge upgrades, you're now going to be going from bronze to silver, stop and go. And all right, for the 15 badge upgrade, for the people with 15 badge upgrades, we're now going to be going from silver to gold, stop and go. So you now have stop and go at the highest possible thing. For the people that do not have Hall of Fame badges, so you're gonna be able to do the fastest quick stops possible, and you're gonna be having be able to do more speed boosts out of hezzies and stuff like that at the highest rate possible, and you're gonna be able to do the teleport glitch at the highest rate possible. So yeah, very important things, big deals. Next we're gonna be getting to the 16 through 30 for the Hall of Fame. So yeah man, let's go ahead, hop straight into it. Alright, so for the people with 16 badge grades, this is now on to the Hall of Fame. So we have Handlers for Days Hall of Fame, Quick First Step Hall of Fame, Floor General Hall of Fame, Unpluckable Hall of Fame. Floor General is going to be getting your teammates plus 4 to all their attributes. I already went over how big of a deal that is. Unpluckable is going to be helping you not get ripped as much as possible. That's a very good, important badge this year. Handlers for Days, another very good and important badge this year. Going to be canceling out the stamina issue. Very good and important. Quick First Step is going to be making you as fast as possible with the ball, helping you get open for anything that you're trying to do. The best badge, the most important badge in this game, especially for playmaking. So yeah, man, that's going to be the badge setup for 16 badge upgrades. All right, next for the people with 17 badge upgrades, you're going to be putting on bronze, stop and go. At the 18th badge upgrade, you're now going to be going from bronze to silver, stop and go. At the 19th badge upgrade, you're now going to be going from silver to gold, stop and go. At the 28th badge upgrade, you're now going to be going from gold to Hall of Fame, stop and go. Now you're going to be able to do pretty much speed boosting out of hezzies at the highest rate possible. You're going to be able to do the teleport glitch at the highest rate possible. And you're going to be able to do the fastest possible quick stops. Very important things in this game. So yeah, man, quick stop and go is the 20th badge grade that we're using it for Hall of Fame. All right, next is going to be for the 21st badge grade. For the people with 21 badge grades, you're now going to be putting on diamond. We haven't even discussed this the entire part of the video. People are probably like, why have you not used that yet? Diamond is a very important badge in this game. Don't get it twisted. Diamond is going to be helping your teammates' shot percentage for open teammates on jump shots after catching a pass. Now, if you show more, it says only in the half court. I don't believe that to be true because it pops up no matter what. But just know, dimer, the higher it is, it gives bigger shot percentage boosts to your teammate shots. So say, for instance, you have floor general. It's going to be showing their percentages to make that shot. Dimer is going to be giving them like 5% or 10% or 15% or 20% chance on top of the percent they already have. So say, for instance, someone has a 28% chance. You can make that like a 48% chance. Or say, for instance, somebody has like a 62% chance. You can make that a 82% chance. So, like, we don't know the exact number it is, but it's gonna, you gotta think of it like that. You know what I'm saying? You're gonna be adding percentage bonuses on top of what they already have of percentage to make their shot. So it's gonna be pretty much making their make shot percentage a lot bigger, making their green window a lot bigger in the meantime too. So that's a really big deal. So yeah, diamond, bronze is the badge we put on for the 21st badge upgrade. All right, next is going to be for the people with 22 badge upgrades. We're now gonna be going from bronze to silver, diamond. And for the 23rd badge upgrade, we're gonna be going from silver to gold, diamond. And for the 24th badge upgrade, for the people with 24 badge upgrades, we're now going to be going from gold to Hall of Fame diamond. That's going to be pretty much giving your teammates the biggest shot percentage boost possible, which is going to be making their make percentage higher and their green window even bigger. Such a big deal in this game. For people that's struggling to shoot, if you can help people shoot at any rate, giving them attribute bonuses, shot percentage bonuses, making huge deals, changing the game. I'm telling you this right now. So yeah. All right, for the 25th badge upgrades, for the people with 25 badge upgrades, we're not going to be putting on needle threader. Needle threader just pretty much makes every pass faster, better, and it goes into tighter windows. So yeah, man, needle threader is probably like the best passing badge in this game. You could argue putting on badges like bailout, but I would go needle threader. And for the 26th badge upgrade, for the people with 26 badge upgrades, we're going to be going from bronze to silver, needle threader. And for the 27th badge upgrade, for the 27th badge upgrade, we're going to be going from silver to gold, needle threader. That's what we're making it just that much better. And for the 28th badge upgrade, for the people with 28 badge upgrades, we're now going to be going from gold to Hall of Fame, needle threader. Now your pass is going to be the fastest, the best possible passes, where it's literally damn near never going to be a turnover, no matter what type of pass you're doing, whether you're doing a bailout, break starter, outlet, whatever you're trying to do, or just trying to make a regular pass in the half court. You know what I'm saying? It's just gonna make every single pass you're doing better, and it's gonna be able to fit through tighter windows a lot more. Even if you're trying to do lobs, flashes, it doesn't matter. It's gonna be making all those passes a lot better. Now, right here, I haven't mentioned this on any other part of this video. I feel like I probably should have mentioned this earlier, but they patch ankle breakers to make it a lot easier to get ankle breakers. You don't get more ankle breakers. You know what I'm saying? It's still the same. So I haven't seen a clip of anyone getting an ankle breaker in the park, rec, pro-am, none of that. Maybe in my career, but nah, not in park, pro-am, none of that. So, yeah. And for the 29th badge upgrade, for the people with 29 badge upgrades, we're now going to be going with bronze bailout. Very important badge to pretty much be able to bail out. It's not as overpowered as last year, where it's going to be able to just be a dot no matter what. This year, every single time, it seems like they bobble it. You have to have, like, Hall of Fame to pretty much make sure that they don't bobble it, so it can be the best pass possible every single time out of a bailout. But it's not an auto turnover, even if they bobble it. Your teammate just has to understand that it's a bailout pass, so they have to be aware of what the ball is finna do. So it's still a good badge, but it's, like, not nearly as overpowered. So, yeah, bronze bailout is going to be the 29th badge of grade that we put on. And last but not least, for the 30th badge of grade, we now don't have Hall of Fame needle threader anymore. We kind of mixed it to have both, the best of both. Bailout bronze and silver isn't that good, but once you go gold and Hall of Fame, it becomes a lot better, where they actually be able to catch it at a consistent rate instead of bobbling it so much. So once we have bailout on gold, it makes a big deal. And needle threader gold is still a very good thing. It's not as good as Hall of Fame, but it's still very good. So we can be able to have gold on both of those while having unpluckable, stop and go, floor general, dimer, handles for days, quick for step, all Hall of Fame. So yeah, man, this is the best badge setup for 1 through 30 for the guard, 1 through 15 for the gold, 16 through 30 for the Hall of Fame. So yeah, man, let's go ahead and hop straight into the big man. Alright, so hopping straight into the big man. First badge grade, for the people with one badge grade, you're going to be putting on quick first step. Now, a lot of people are going to be like, why would you do that? Because, you know what I'm saying, it just makes your build a lot better. It's just going to be that simple. But trust me. Put on quick first step bronze, it's going to make a big difference. Alright, for the people with two badge grades, you're now going to be going from bronze to silver, quick first step. And for the people with three badge grades, you're now going to be going from silver to gold, quick first step. Now, quick first step is a badge that affects any build, no matter if you can speed boost at the highest tier or not. There's tiers to speed boosting, believe it or not. And if you don't have quick first step, you're not going to be able to speed boost at the highest rate possible for your tier. You have to have quick first step on to be able to speed boost at the highest rate for your tier. Now, speed boosting is not really what is called momentum. Speed boosting is like how fast you can go in and out of breaks and stuff like that. Like, for the first step, you know what I'm saying? Like, off of hezzies and stuff like that. Out of dribble moves and stuff like that. So, quick first step is something that you can use to catch people off guard. So, that's why people like to use three badger grades on their builds. To be able to, be able to get quick first step gold, to be able to throw people off. Because some people just don't expect big man to be able to move like that. So, yeah, man, quick first step gold is the badge we put on for three badge upgrades. For the fourth badge upgrade, for the people with four badge upgrades, we now have on post spin technician. Bronze post spin technician actually is a very good badge for big men this year, because big men don't all have post move lockdown. A lot of big men this year actually have 30, but they still not using post move lockdown like that. So post spin technician on bronze is going to actually be very useful this year. So yeah, man, post spin technician is going to actually be making you be able to improve your ability of doing a post spin. So yeah, whether you want to do a drive or a post spin out of the post, it's going to really make it that much better or easier to do. All right, next, for the people with five badger grades, you're now going to be going from bronze to silver post spin technician. All right, now, for the people with six badger grades, you're now going to be going from silver to gold post spin technician. Now you're going to be able to do post spins or drive out of the post at the highest rate, at the most effective rate possible. All right, next, a very underrated badge for big men is unpluckable. If you're wondering why, as a big man, you get ripped out of the poles, you're getting ripped in general, unpluckable is the reason. Pluckable, very important for big men this year. I'm just going to be letting that know right now, off the get-go. So, yeah, unpluckable is a very good badge to have on. Very important to have on. So, yeah, unpluckable is going to be the badge we put on for the seventh badge upgrade. For the eighth badge upgrade, for the people with eight badge upgrades, we're now going to be going from bronze to silver unpluckable. And for the ninth badge upgrade, for the people with nine badge upgrades, we're now going to be going from silver to gold unpluckable. Now you're going to be able to not get ripped at the highest rate possible for anybody that cannot have Hall of Fame badges. All right, next is going to be the 10th badge grade. For the people with 10 badge grades, we're going to be going with bronze needle threader. That's going to be making any pass better. Whether you're doing a lob, a flashy pass, a break starter pass, a bailout pass, it doesn't really matter. It's going to be making that pass a lot better, a lot faster, and harder to get a turnover off of when it comes to being a pass, being a bad pass, or just somebody be able to steal the pass. So yeah, needle threader is a very important badge. It's very underutilized, and it's the best passing badge in the game. So yeah, man, that's the badge we go with for the 10th badge upgrade. For the 11th badge upgrade, for the people with 11 badge upgrades, we're now going to be going from bronze to silver needle threader. And for the 12th badge upgrade, we're going to be going with gold needle threader. That's going to be making your passes the best possible for anyone that cannot have Hall of Fame. Whether you're doing a bailout, break starter, lob, flashy, it doesn't really matter. Or if you just don't want to get turnovers off your passes in general. Needle threader is going to be the best passing badge in this game, hands down, for you. All right, next, for the 13th badge upgrade, we're going to be going with break starter. Break starter is going to be helping your outlet passes at an all-time rate. And yeah, going on top of needle threader is just going to be that much better. So yeah, man, if you're getting rebounds and trying to do leak out passes, break starter is going to be a very good badge for you. And for the 14th badge upgrade, for the people with 14 badge upgrades, we're now going to be going from bronze to silver break starter. And for the 15th badge upgrade, for the people with 15 badge upgrades, we're now going to be going from silver to gold break starter. That's going to be making your outlet passes off of rebounds at the best possible passes off of rebounds at the highest rate possible. On top of needle threader, it's even going to be even faster and all that type of stuff. So yeah, man, break starter is going to be a very good badge for you if you're doing anything like that. So yeah, man, break starter gold is the badge we went on for the 15th badge upgrade. For the 1 through 15 for the gold. So yeah, man, let's go ahead and do the 16 through 30 for the Hall of Fame for the big man. So yeah, man, let's hop straight into it. All right, so hopping straight into the 16 through 30, starting off with the 16th badge upgrade. For the people with 16 badge upgrades, we're now going to have Hall of Fame badges. So, Quick First Step Hall of Fame, Floor General Hall of Fame, Dimer Hall of Fame. Dimer Hall of Fame is going to be a very important badge to be able to help your teammates' shot percentages. So, you want to help your teammates' shot percentages. It's going to be giving them a boost on top of the shot percentage they already have for the certain spots they're in. If you have Floor General, you're going to be seeing a lot of shot percentages on the floor. Dimer is going to be going on top of what they already have, making it a lot better. And then Floor General, if you don't know what this does, at Hall of Fame, it actually shows the percentages of all your teammates in the spots they're in, whether they're contested, not contested, all that type of stuff. And it's also going to be giving them plus 4 to all their offensive attributes at Hall of Fame. So that's going to be very important for them to hit tiers. Like if they're trying to hit a tier for the 85, 90, 95, 99, 80, or 75, 3-point rating, or if they're trying to just hit the 86 ball handler rating, or try to hit the 86 speed with ball rating to be able to speed boost. So yeah, man, if you can help somebody hit any type of tier, or even help them get to a certain point, and you expecting them to get a certain point to take over, any type of help you can do is going to really make them be that much better of a player. And then we got quick first step. That's going to be pretty much the most overpowered badge you see here, especially for a big man, because that's just going to be making you that much faster with the ball. And like I was saying earlier, you have tiers to speed boosting. When it comes to these tiers of speed boosting, you're not going to be as fast as you possibly can if you don't have quick first step at the highest rate. So Hall of Fame quick first step is going to have you speed boosting at the highest rate for whatever tier of speed boosting you are already at. The highest tier is at 86 speed with ball, but there are tiers under that. People don't understand that. But next, we got the gold badge, unpluckable. That's going to be helping you not get ripped as much as possible. Then we got bronze, post-spin technician, so that whenever you're trying to do anything in the post, because people don't really use post-move lockdown like that, so you're going to be able to have that on bronze and still be able to do post-moves or post-drives out of the post. So yeah, that's very, very important. This is the best badge setup for people with 16 badge upgrades. All right, for the 17th badge upgrade, we're now going to be going from gold to Hall of Fame, unpluckable. Now you're not going to be getting ripped at the highest rate possible, so your ball handle is going to be getting ripped as less as possible. And for the people with 18 badger grades, for the people with the 18th badger grade, you're going to be going from bronze to silver, post spin technician. And for the 19th badger grade, for the people with 19 badger grades, you're now going to be going from silver to gold, post spin technician. And for the 20th badger grade, for the people with 20 badger grades, you're now going to be going from gold to Hall of Fame, post spin technician. That's going to be making you be able to spin and drive out of the post no matter what their post move lockdown is. It's going to have, they're going to have to literally add that on Hall of Fame to cancel you out as much as possible. And people don't use that at Hall of Fame. So you're going to be able to do the post move when it comes to spins or drives out of post at the highest efficiency possible. All right, next for the 21st badger grade, you're now going to be going with needle threader on bronze. That's going to be pretty much making you do the best passes possible. And for the people with 22 badger grades, you're now going to be going from bronze to silver needle threader. And for the people with the 23rd badger grade, for the people with 23 badger grades, you're now going to be going from silver to gold needle threader. And for the 24th badger grade, for the people with 24 badger grades, you're now going to be going from gold to Hall of Fame needle threader. That's going to be making you do the best passes possible, whether you're doing an outlet pass, a bailout pass, a flashy pass, a lob city pass, or just not trying to get a turnover in general. It's going to be giving you the best possible pass in the game. Now, that is depending on your passing rating, but it's going to be making your passing rating that much better. All right, next for the people with 25 badger grades, you're now going to be putting on bailout. Bailout is a badge that's going to be making a big deal on if you're getting turnovers or not, passing out of bad animation. Whether you're doing a bad shot attempt, a bad layup animation, a bad dunk animation, whatever it may be, it's going to be making you pass out of those. Now, this badge is not nearly as overpowered as it was last year where they would catch it damn near every time. This year, they have a chance of catching it, but they're going to pretty much do like a bobble with it. So the lower it is, the more it's going to bobble, the higher it is, the less it's going to bobble, and the more accurate of a pass it's going to be. So you got to keep that in mind. All right, next is going to be for the people with 26 badger grades. You're going to be going from bronze to silver bailout. And for the 27th badger grade, for the people with 27 badger grades, we're now going to be going for gold bailout. And for the 28th badger grade, for the people with 28 badger grades, now going to be going for Hall of Fame bailout. That's going to be having you be able to do bailouts out of any animation, whether you're doing a bad shot attempt, a bad layup animation, or any bad animation in general, or even out of double teams. It's going to be making you do the best, most accurate, least bobbled passes possible out of any type of situation you're trying to get bailed out of and you're trying to pass out of. So yeah, man, bailout is now on Hall of Fame for the 28th badge upgrade. For the 29th badge upgrade, you're now going to be going with brick starter on bronze. And for the 30th badger grade, we now have even out bailout on gold with break starter on gold. So now you have on break starter gold, so you can be able to do the best outlet passes possible without having Hall of Fame. So it's going to be damn near as good as possible. Bailout is going to be damn near as good as possible at getting you bailed out of any bad animation, whether you're doing a shot, a dunk, a layup, whatever it may be, double team, it doesn't really matter. You're going to have needle threader to do the best passes possible. Post beam technician to be able to do the most efficient spins or drives out of the post. Floor general is going to be giving you +4 to all your teammates' attributes. Diamond is going to be giving them the biggest shot bonuses to all the shots that they take for whatever spot they're in, contest or no contest, it doesn't really matter. Unpluckable is going to help them not get ripped as much as possible. And then you got quick first step, which is going to be the best badge, the most important badge to any badge setup in any 2K21 build. It doesn't really matter. So yeah, quick first step is going to be on Hall of Fame, making you that much faster, that much better at speed boosting for whatever tier of speed boost you are. All right, now that we got that all out the way, let's go ahead and hop into the badge setup. So for the badge setup, we're gonna go from the guards to the bigs, just like we always do it, 1 through 15 for the goal, 16 through 30 for the Hall of Fame. So we're going to hop straight into the guards off rip. So the first Badger grade, for the people with one Badger grade, you're going to be putting on bronze clamps. That's going to be pretty much making you play the best on-ball defense possible, whether you're going ISO, full court, half court, screens, it doesn't really matter, but it's really going to be mainly here to be able to stop people from blowing by you and stuff like that. And the higher it is, the better it is going to be at resisting people from blowing by you. All right, for the second Badger grade, for the people with two Badger grades, we're now going to go for bronze, two silver clamps. And for the third Badger grade, for the people with three Badger grades, you're now going to go from silver to gold clamps. Now you're going to have the best blow-by resistance for people that do not have Hall of Fame, and you're going to be playing the best on-ball defense for pretty much any type of situation, whether you're playing full court, half court, ISO, or screens. It's going to be playing the best on-ball defense possible for anyone that cannot get Hall of Fame badges. All right, next, spoiler alert on the big men and guards. I'm not putting Intimidator above bronze. Intimidator this year is very, very inconsistent with the contest. Now, in the paint, contests in the paint are just very consistent in general. But when it comes to the perimeter, it's really no point of like really exactly expecting Intimidator to make a big deal. So I haven't seen a big difference between bronze, silver, gold, and Hall of Fame. So I just keep it at bronze. For right now, as of right now, this is what I use, bronze Intimidator, even if I'm a big or a guard. Now, if I'm a big, I use a different badge to get the best contest possible, like when it comes to like the best animations possible and stuff like that for defense. But for the guards, when it comes to shot contests on the perimeter and stuff like that, Intimidator bronze is all I use. All right, next, for the people with five badge of grades, we're going to go with bronze Interceptor. That's going to be having you in the passing lanes, getting the most passing lane steals possible. All right, next, for the people with six Badger grades, you're now going to go from bronze to silver Interceptor. For my people with seven Badger grades, you're now going to go for bronze Pick Dodge. And Pick Dodge is a very important badge this year, where people all have these play shots or these paint beasts. You have to have on Pick Dodge so that you can be able to go through screens, slip through screens as much as possible. Now, I know a lot of people don't want to try to even get hit by screens, they try to go around it. But for any type of situation where the screen is actually set on you, you want to have Pick Dodge so you can slip through those as easily and as fast as possible. And for the 8th Badger grade, we're now going to go from bronze to silver Pick Dodger. And for the 9th Badger grade, you're now going to go from silver to gold Pick Dodger. Now you're going to be slipping through screens and going through screens as fast as possible for anyone that can't get Hall of Fame badges. And for the 10th Badger grade, you're now going to have gold Interceptor. And that's going to be having you in them passing lanes at the highest rate possible, getting more passing lane steals than ever before, especially for people that cannot get Hall of Fame badges. Alright, next, for the people with 11 Badger grades, you're now going to be putting on Tireless Defender. That's going to be pretty much canceling out the stamina issue on defense so you can be able to play defense as long as possible, which is also important when it comes to guarding people on defense in this game. When you're going through screens, when Brick Wall is also going to be taking people's energy, Tireless Defender is going to be helping your stamina stay at a higher rate. And this also, it's actually supposedly had a buff in the latest patch, so it's supposed to be working a lot better than before, but it was already a pretty decent badge this year. So yeah, Tyler's Defender, very good badge to put on. All right, next, one of the most underrated badges in this game. For the 12th badge of grade, we're going to be putting on Off-Ball Pest. Now, dexing is very overpowered, but not only does this help with dexing, it also helps for people that like to throw lobs, so you can get those bumps so that they can't catch the lob and stuff like that. So yeah, if you can guard dexing, you can guard bump on, you can bump people on the lobs, it's going to make a big difference. So yeah, we're putting on Off-Ball Pest, and it's going to be making you pretty much play the best off-ball defense possible, getting a lot of bumps, getting people body, harassing the defender off the ball. Next is going to be for the people with 13 Badger grades. We're now going to be going with Silver Off-Ball Pest. And for the people with 14 Badger grades, you're now going to go from Silver to Gold Off-Ball Pest. Now you're going to be playing the best on off-ball defense possible when it comes to bumping and harassing the defender or offensive player, and it's going to be helping you pretty much guard those people that want to dex and catch lobs at the highest rate possible. And all right, last but not least, for the goal, for the 15th badge upgrade, we're now going to be going from bronze to silver Tyler's Defender. That's going to be making you play the better on ball off ball defense. You're trying to play with the highest stamina possible. So yeah, that's gonna be pretty much the bad setup for the 1 through 15 for the guard for the gold. All right, so hopping into the Hall of Fame 16 through 30. So for the 16 Badger grade, we now have Hall of Fame Clamps, Hall of Fame Intimidator, Hall of Fame Pick Dodger, Silver Off-Ball Pest, Bronze Tireless Defender, and Bronze Intimidator. For the 17th Badger grade, we're now going to be going with Gold Off-Ball Pest. And for the 18th Badger grade, we're now going to be going Hall of Fame off-ball pass. It's going to be pretty much making you play the best off-ball defense possible when it comes to people that want to dex and people that want to catch lobs. And all right, next is going to be for the people that have 19 Badger grades. You're not going to be going with Silver Tireless Defender. And next is going to be for the people that have 20 Badger grades. You're not going to be going from Silver to Gold Tireless Defender. And for the 21st Badger grade, you're not going to be going from Gold to Hall of Fame Tireless Defender. Now your stamina is going to be at an all-time high when on defense, which is going to be making a big difference when you have Hall of Fame Pick Dodger, Hall of Fame Tireless Defender to completely cancel out that brick wall badge, which sets the best screens possible and also drains your energy. So you have the two badges that's very important to cancel out that badge, which is very, very important. All right, next is going to be for the 22nd Badger grade. We're now going with Rim Protector. This is going to be pretty much the best paint defense badge in the game. Now, paint defense in this game is already amazing. But with that being said, you want to have Rim Protector on so you can get a lot more blocks and stuff like that. Because it unlocks all different type of block animations. It just makes your player a lot better in that paint when it comes to just getting better contests and even getting better block animations. And even be able to help you and your teammates take over, which is actually a big deal in this game. Alright, next for the people with 23 Badger grades, we're now going from Bronze to Silver Rim Protector. And for the 24th Badger grade, we're now going from Silver to Gold Rim Protector. And for the 25th Badger grade, we're now going to be going from Gold to Hall of Fame Rim Protector, making you play the best paint defense possible. That's going to be getting you more snatch blocks, best block animations, and it's going to be helping your teammates take over for whenever you do get a block animation. And for the 26th Badger grade, we're now going to be going with Bronze Pickpocket. That's going to be pretty much helping you get more steals on ball. That's going to be canceling out the unpluckable badge that guards have, so you can be able to rip people a lot more. Next is going to be for the people that have 27 Badger grades. You're now going to be going from Bronze to Silver Pickpocket. And for the 28th Badger grade, for the people with 28 Badger grades, you're now going to be going from Silver to Gold Pickpocket. And for the 29th Badger grade, for the people with 29 Badger grades, you're now going to be going from Silver to Gold all the way to Hall of Fame now Pickpocket. And that's going to be pretty much make you get the most steals on ball, and it's going to be improving your ability to steal the ball from a ball handler at the highest rate possible. And last but not least for the guards, one of the most underrated things that you can have as a guard is rebound chaser. For the 30th Badger grade, for the people with 30 Badger grades, you're not going to be putting on Bronze rebound chaser. That's going to be making your player rebound at a whole nother rate, no matter what your rebound is, especially if you have your rebounding max. So yeah, that's going to actually make a big difference on your build. So yeah, go ahead, throw on that rebound chaser. All right, so hopping into the big man. So now we're gonna go from 1 through 15 for the gold, then we're gonna do the 16 to 30 for the Hall of Fame for the big man. So first Badger grade, for the people with one Badger grade, you're gonna be putting on rebound chaser. That's gonna be helping you get the best rebound animations, the best snag animations possible. So yeah, man, if you want to get as many rebounds as possible, go ahead, throw on that rebound chaser. For the people with two Badger grades, you're not gonna go from Bronze to Silver rebound chaser. And for the people with three Badger grades, you're not going to be going from Silver to Gold rebound chaser. Now you're going to be able to get the best snag animations, as many rebounds as possible for the people that cannot have Hall of Fame rebound chaser. Now, is that saying that you are at a disadvantage from people that have Hall of Fame rebound chaser? Yes, but you can still do what you can do with your build with rebound chaser if you know what you're doing. So yeah. Alright, next is going to probably be the most important badge in this game for big men, for the way people like to play. It's going to be Brick Wall. We now have on Brick Wall Bronze. That's going to be making you set the best screens, the hardest screens, make people stick to your screens as much as possible, while also be able to drain people's energy on physical contact. So if you're doing screens, boxing out, anything that you're doing that creating physical contact on a different level, you're going to be draining people's energy, and it's also going to be helping you set screens. So this is going to help you pretty much set screens to get open for lobs, help your teammate get open, whatever you're trying to do. So yeah, this is like the meta, the way people want to play on this game, setting screens. So yeah, we have Brick Wall on Bronze. For the people with five Badger grades, you're not going to be going from Bronze to Silver Brick Wall. And for the people with six Badger grades, you're not going to be going from Silver to Gold Brick Wall. Now you're going to be setting the best screens possible and be draining as much energy as possible for people that do not have Hall of Fame badges. All right, next, I mentioned this on the guard, but this is a badge that I don't feel like you have to raise above Bronze. So I'm going to go ahead and break this down right here. Intimidator is going to stay at Bronze because the difference between Silver, Gold, Hall of Fame, and Bronze Intimidator, I don't really see the biggest difference. I feel like it's just there to help shot contest when the paint defense is already what it is. There's no need to really have Intimidator above bronze. You want to have it on, for sure. That's why we're going with bronze. But it's just going to help you get the best shot contest possible. But in this game, they nerfed it so much that it doesn't really make a difference at all from each one. So, yeah, that's going to help you get perimeter defense or contest or interior defense contest. So, yeah. All right, next is going to be the badge that helps you with the most on paint defense. And it's going to be Rim Protector. So, the people with 8 badge upgrades, you're not going to be putting on bronze Rim Protector. That's going to help your player not only... their ability to get blocks is going to also unblock block animations, whether it's a snatch block or any type of block animation, kind of like contact dumps for big men. They give you like block animations for Rim Protector, where you put the people into animations and you also give your teammates and yourself takeover bonus. So yeah, that's a big boost. So yeah, Rim Protector is going to be the badge we put on for the 8th badge upgrade. And for the 9th badge upgrade, we're now going to go from bronze to silver Rim Protector. And for the 10th badge upgrade, we're now going to go from silver to gold Rim Protector. Now you're going to be able to pretty much improve your ability to get blocks at the highest rate. Get as many block animations as possible that you wouldn't be able to have if you didn't have it on. Unless you had Hall of Fame Rim Protector. And then you're going to be giving your teammates the biggest boost possible to their takeovers for anyone that cannot get Hall of Fame badges. Alright, next is going to be... for the people that have 11 badge upgrades, you're going to go with bronze interceptor. That's going to have you in them passing lanes, getting as many passing lane steals as much as possible, making you lunge a lot harder for these steals, catch 4 steals and stuff like that. So yeah, man, interceptor is the badge we go with for the 11th badge upgrade. All right, next is going to be for the people with 12 badge upgrades, you're now going to go from bronze to silver interceptor. And for the people with 13 badge upgrades, you're now going to go from silver to gold interceptor. That's going to be having you in them lanes as much as possible, diving for balls as much as possible, and even catching passes as much as possible. So yeah, that's a big deal. It's a really big deal. It's the difference between tipping a ball and a ball that's out of your reach and a ball that you actually are just catching. All right, next. This is really depending on which one you feel like you need more. I personally would probably go with Worm, but I feel like Box is the more popular one, so I would go with Box for the 14th badge upgrade. So if you have 14 badge upgrades, you're going to be putting on bronze box. That's going to be improving your player's ability to box out opponents. Now, a lot of people might feel like they don't necessarily need that, but depending on what takeover you chose, if you didn't go glass in your takeover, you're going to be pretty much like you have glass in your takeover. Now that you have box on, it's going to be pretty much making your box out very hard to get around unless they have Worm. They're going to have that on just to be able to get around your box out. And last but not least, for the gold side, we're going to be going for the 15th badge upgrade. For the people with 15 badge upgrades, we're not going to be putting on bronze box. Or not bronze box. Bronze Worm. Now, personally, I would have went Worm first. That's why I was kind of tripping right there. But Worm allows rebounders to swim or spin around box out more easily. So, you know how when people have glass near takeover and they get around box out, that's kind of what Worm does without even just having a glass takeover. So, it's not as easy to do it, but it allows you to. The higher it is, the easier it becomes to be able to do that type of stuff. So, yeah. And all right, hopping into the Hall of Fame 16 through 30 badge upgrade. So for the 16th badge upgrade, it'll be with 16 badge upgrades. You're going to start off with Hall of Fame Brick Wall, Hall of Fame Rim Protector, Hall of Fame Rebound Chaser, Gold Interceptor, and Bronze Intimidator. For my people with 17 badge upgrades, you're now going to go with Interceptor on Hall of Fame. Now you're going to be in them passing lanes at the highest rate possible, getting the best launches for passing lane steals as much as possible. It's going to be the biggest difference between you not catching the ball and catching the ball, or either tipping the ball and catching the ball. All those big differences that are very underrated, you're not going to be able to catch those passing lane steals as much as possible. And it's going to really help big men, the biggest, when it comes to lobs. Lobs are very, very hard to stop in this game, and Interceptor is one way that you can cancel that out. Now, there are other badges that we're going to talk about later on, but Interceptor is a big deal when it comes to canceling out lobs, and that's a big deal in this game. All right, next is going to be probably the most overpowered badge in the game. Now, I waited a little bit to put this on because those other badges are just more important to having on for a big man. But this badge is very overpowered. It decreases opponents' takeover meters when achieving a highlight play on defense. So, whether you're getting a steal or a block, you're going to be pretty much making... it's going to be taking their takeover meter down. So say for instance off the rip, the higher you have it, you can make people go cold off that. That's making a big deal. So yeah, man, we have on bronze Heart Crusher for the 18th badge upgrade. For the 19th badge upgrade, we're not going to go from bronze to silver Heart Crusher. And for the people with 20 badge upgrades, you're not going to go from silver to gold Heart Crusher. And for the people with 21 badge upgrades, you're not going to go from gold to Hall of Fame Heart Crusher. That's going to be pretty much taking the biggest... it's really going to be decreasing opponents' takeover at the highest rate possible. So, say for instance, you start the game off with a steal, you're going to be decreasing their takeover. You could maybe make them go cold. You start the game off with a block, you can make them go cold. It's really a big deal, and what makes it very overpowered is it affects the entire team. All right, next is going to be a badge that's very important. Very, very important. This badge is going to be canceling out lobs at an all-time rate. So you already have intercepted, we get them passing lane steals on lobs as the highest rate possible. Now you have on off-ball pass for when people are trying to cut for those lobs, you can bump them as much as possible to be able to throw off that lob and make that turn into an automatic turnover so they can't even get into the lob animation. So yeah, man, off-ball pass is actually a very underrated badge. I've mentioned this many, many times, even in the rankings video, I talked about it. But yeah, I'm talking about it again in this video. Off-ball pass is the badge we go on to pretty much be able to bump and harass people off the ball. All right, next is going to be Clamps. We had this joint on to be able to play the best on-ball defense possible. Maybe we have to get switch onto somebody. So yeah, we have Clamps on bronze. That's going to be pretty much helping you play the best on-ball defense, whether you're going around screen, but mainly ISO, full court, half court, and it's going to really stop people from being able to blow by you at the highest rate possible. And it even can help make people pick up their dribble and stuff like that. All right, next is going to be a very important badge. This is going to be Worm. This is going to allow rebounders to swim or spin around box outs more easily. So if you want to get around box outs easy, put on Worm. You know how when you have the glass in your takeover and somebody's trying to box you out, you get around that instantly? That's kind of like Worm is going to do. It's not going to be at the same rate, but the higher it is, it's going to be the better. All right, next, for the people with 25 badge grades, you're going to go from bronze to silver, Worm. And for the people with 26 badge grades, you're now going to go from silver to gold, Worm. And for the 27 badger grades, for the people with 27 badger grades, you're now going to go from gold to Hall of Fame Worm. That's going to be pretty much helping you get around box outs at the highest rate possible. And now for the people with 28 badger grades, you're now going to go for box. That's going to be pretty much helping you box out opponents at the highest rate possible. And now they have to have on Worm to be able to get around your box out or glass in your takeover. All right, next. This is a badge that got nerfed, but it's very underrated this year. And it's Pogo Stick. Improved the ability to attempt multiple blocks in succession. Now, the biggest difference from this year to last year is the fact that it doesn't let you just keep jumping and jumping and jumping no matter what you have it on. It doesn't let you do that. That was what made undersized centers so important last year and so overpowered. This year, the reason why it's kind of needed is because the offensive players this year, they can get rebounds and put it back up very, very fast. So to cancel that out, you have to have on Pogo Stick so that you can be able to jump as fast as possible on that first jump. So say for instance, you go up for a jump and you make a miss, he gets the rebound, he comes back down, he can go up with it fast. So you want to have on Pogo Stick to be able to cancel that type of stuff out. And last but not least, for the 30th Badger grade, for the people with 30 Badger grades, we're now going to be going with Bronze Chase Down Artist. It's not as overpowered as last year, where it like pretty much would just make you be able to get a chase down block almost every single time, pretty much guaranteed. This year is not nearly as overpowered. You might be able to get one or two a game at the highest. You might even be able to get three on a good day, or four or five. Depends on what you're going against. If you're going to get some trash, you know what I'm saying? But more than likely, you barely going to be able to even get one. And they actually supposedly buffed it, but at the same time, they nerfed it. Now, this year, it supposedly helped your speed and vertical. Last year, it only supposedly helped your vertical. But what it says is raises the chances of getting a chase down block. Now, what this does is it allows you to get the chase down block animations once you put it to bronze. Then you go to silver, you're going to be faster and you're going to jump higher. Then you get gold, you're gonna be faster and jump higher. Then you go to Hall of Fame, you're gonna be faster and jump higher. So we have it on bronze just so we can actually have the ability to actually be able to get a chase down block at all. So yeah, that's gonna be the bad setup for the big men 16 through 30. But yeah, man, that's going to be the end of this video. I went over everything in this video for the finishing, the shooting, the playmaking, and the Hall of Fame. 1 through 15 for the goal, 16 to 30 for the Hall of Fame. So yeah, man, for that alone, go ahead, please do drop a like. It will help this video get to more people. It will make this video do even better if you drop a like. So if you want to support in any type of way possible, drop a like. But if you are new to the channel, please do drop a sub. We're on that road to 100K. So I really would appreciate if you just support by dropping a sub and dropping a like. That really helps a lot. You know what I'm saying? It really helps a lot. You know what I'm saying? So I really would appreciate it. But yeah, turn on post notifications. Be the first to have you, one of my videos, because this is Banger Week. If you want to be to enter and to get one of these codes, you got to be ready for Banger Week, man. Just that simple. So yeah, if you guys want to be able to get to the calls as fast as possible, faster than everybody else, you want to have on these post notifications turned on. Next is going to be sharing this video to anybody that as well. I know this video could help somebody, so go ahead, share it. You know what I'm saying? It's just that simple. But yeah, man, without further ado, it's your boy Fitz, man, and I'm about to be, man. Head in the clouds, walk through the city, they taking you out.
Bitches be talking, they running their mouth. A bag in the back and a stick in the couch. You know what it's about. Had to cope with all the pain, so I'm about to die. Amen. They say he going too fast.